You are watching UNICEF television.
Okay, this is a Matenjwa family. They are not even comfortable to spend quality time around because they are scared.
A visit from Shoulder to Crown community workers allows three orphaned sisters an opportunity to leave the security of their home to clear their overgrown yard. The girls inherited the two-bedroom house when their father died last year. Their mother had died a few years before. Many people in this rural community in the Limpopo province in Swaziland die from AIDS. This southern African kingdom has the highest HIV rate in the world. The girls fear to be caught outside alone by their 40-year-old uncle.
The youngest is 7 years. He's presently not here because their uncle came through the window and beat all of them and told the youngest child who is 7 years to undress because there is no child that can sleep dressed.
The girls escaped to a neighbor's Zandile Mumbali's house to get help. Zandile is one of 11,000 volunteer child protectors trained by Shoulder to Cry On. Across the country, they're the first line of defense for many children. A 2007 survey conducted by UNICEF and the US Center for Disease Control revealed alarmingly high levels of violence against girls in Swaziland. Approximately one-third of girls younger than 18 experienced sexual abuse, and one in four had been physically abused. In response, the government, along with UNICEF, NGOs and civil society, have taken more serious measures against abuse and want to create a culture of zero tolerance. Kandile Zwane, Senior Crown Counsel, has been prosecuting individuals who violate children's rights. Kandile works in a specifically designed victim-friendly space built with support from UNICEF. Together with the police, she tries to gather enough evidence to take cases of sexually abused children to the High Court.
The purpose of this room is to enable the child to be able to play around and not to really concentrate on what they're really saying. So when you're interviewing them, you usually ask them as to what was daddy wearing on this particular day when this happened. Then if the child cannot really talk or say whatever happened to them, we usually give them the dolls to demonstrate to us what happened. So this is usually daddy, this one here. What did he do to you? So if, for instance, she was first assaulted, the child will show you that daddy hit me first or whatever. And then the child will show you, for instance, that this was her. Maybe if she was not wearing a panty, she'll tell you, she'll take it out and say, I was not wearing a panty or I was bathing.
Despite Kandile's passion, successful prosecutions are a long, difficult process. As part of the state strategy, police have set up units to tackle abuse in each of Swaziland's 24 police stations. They're working closely with community police and child protection volunteers. Community involvement is crucial, as children often know their abusers. Protecting children in this patriarchal and tradition-bound kingdom remains a challenge. Yet these initiatives are starting to make a difference, even in the remote areas. This is Shanta Blumen reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.